That doesn't look good.
No, that doesn't.
Hard hit into turn one wall. Oh, my goodness.
Kevin Langton.
Kevin Langton in the 24 and the 44. Oh. And the one, it looks like.
I came round with the big dogs. I lay on the pole. Lay here and not even move. I've been over the road and under the house. I ain't got nothing to prove. I'm a little bit lazy when it comes to love. I take my own easy time. I don't like being pushed. Don't like being shoved when I make love or make up my mind. I can hang in and hang out, but I'll be right here till I know the rules of the game. I can run with the big dogs or lay on the porch. I find it all pays the same.
Welcome to Memorial Field for the fifth annual charity softball team game between the Busch North Series drivers and the Busch Grand National South drivers here at Memorial Field in Concord. I'm Dave Stevens, getting our play-by-play with Pete Barker. Pete, how you doing tonight?
Well, not too bad.
Pete's a veteran play-by-play guy. I'm just kind of a race guy. So
it's about it.
We have got quite a game going on for us tonight. The Busch Grand National drivers, the South drivers, we'll refer to as them, leads this series 3-1. Sort of embarrassing showing by our Busch North squad the last few years, Pete. But this year, they've got a few surprises. What they are, I'm not sure.
No, and I guess Elton, from what I was reading, Elton Sawyer of the Grand National Group says that we're confident we can extend the series lead to 4-1, so evidently the surprises better be in store for the North.
Well, we did spike his punch a little earlier during dinner, so maybe, hopefully he won't be quite as effective on the field as he has been in other games. This is a regulation 7-inning softball game. And how many players go on the field for a regulation softball game, Pete?
Depends on whether you're playing, well, it depends on whether you're playing a short fielder. So you'd be talking about 10, I guess, in this. You're going to put 10 in there?
I see a right center and
a
left center, so that's going to kick it up a little bit,
I'm used to the high school version where you have the basic three outfielders and four infielders and the catcher and the pitcher.
That's a lot.
Right. What they do here is they put that extra person in. So you basically had a fourth outfielder.
Well, we got the teams taking the field right now, and this is our Busch North drivers that are out here, and let's run down who those folks are. At shortstop, it's going to be Glenn Brio. Bobby Dragon will be playing first base. Matt Kobyluck, driver of the Mohegan Sun sponsored Busch North Car, will be playing third base. Mike Olsen in left center field. Bryon Chu of the 09 Buzz Chu Racing Team will be playing in left field. John Lesniak in right center. Barry Belanger will be pitching for the Busch North squad. Ozzy Osborne, acting as race director this weekend, will be filling in at second base tonight. Randy Varney in right field, and Jim St. John will be catching for the Busch North squad this evening. And they're out on the mound right now talking about the strategy for the first inning and how they're going to handle the Busch South squad.
Batting first, the driver of the number two, AC Delco.
Here in the background, the voice of Fred Neergard, the public relations director for New Hampshire International Speedway. Also in the announcer's booth up at NHIS, Al Robinson will be helping out Fred. You'll hear him in the background as well. And Al Robinson also the director of media services for Busch North this year. Tim Fidowa being introduced to the crowd right now. Be playing left center field.
The defending champion of the Busch 200. Driving
captain of the South team.
Please welcome Elton Sawyer.
Elton Sawyer being introduced to the crowd as the shortstop and coach of the team.
The big gun driving for Rockwell, Mike Dillon.
Mike Dillon, left fielder. I don't have a lot of stats on Dillon. Do you have anything there off the top of your head?
No.
No.
Not at all.
Not at all. Good looking bunch of guys, though.
Good looking bunch of guys, and as you say. But you're familiar, of course, with the North group.
Linden Amick, a good driver from down south.
Mm-hmm.
He's being introduced on the field now. We know a lot about their driving history, not quite so much about their softball history.
Well, we're going to find out about that pretty quickly, I guess.
Jimmie Johnson being introduced now and taking the field.
Well, evidently, they're not being introduced in the order of they're going to bat, at least since we have a different batting order, right?
That's why I'm listening to Fred over here.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. So.
Batting seventh, driving for GMAC, please welcome this year's pitcher, Ricky Hendrick.
Okay, so he's going to be seventh. Okay, so we don't, at this point, we don't have the correct order on this sheet.
But we'll have to play it by ear. We have somebody that can help us right here with the batting order if we get a little too combobulated. P.J. Jones being introduced on the field now. Turned out to be a beautiful Thursday evening. The skies have cleared. The sun is out.
Your catcher.
The Memorial Field crew has done an excellent job preparing the field. Randy LaJoie from Norwalk, Connecticut.
You knew the Memorial Field crew. I'd seen them back here in a baseball tournament in 94. And if anybody can do what they can, they have to, considering the amount of rain. There was some rain that year, too, and they did a great job. You wouldn't know it out there that it had rained by looking at that infield.
Blaise Alexander being introduced to the crowd now. And they've got a couple of extras, Franklin Butler and Ricky Veras. So the start of the game is just moments away.
Very true, Al. Very true. All right, well.
Pitchers are warming up right now.
Ready to play softball?
So I guess this is going to be a fast pitch game. Pete, I didn't see the long looping ball from the pitcher's mound.
Let's get ready to rumble!
And of course, we're watching this on New England Cable Channel 12. Where you normally see Granite State Racing. But when we see the drivers get other exercise other than walking to and from their cars in the pits, it's a good thing.
Mm-hmm.
Here we go. Yeah, we have our batting order right here. And I think we've got it pretty much right. We've got Kevin Harrick, Tim Fidowa.
Please, let's remember this wonderful person.
Kevin Harvick is first. If you don't mind, we can share that with you.
You think we'll have to? Because I had written some names down that did not go with that.
Thank you very much. Tonight's umpires are from...
Umpires are being introduced on the field now.
State Police.
and they're all New Hampshire State policemen. Now, I don't know, it's been my experience, Peter, that the New Hampshire State Police have been known to take a bribe or two, depending on what their needs are. Pete, smiling, you've certainly walked away from a couple of speeding tickets in your life.
No, trouble is I have, well, I got lucky. I didn't bribe anybody.
No, it should be a good game. We bring the police in here to keep control of the crowd and make sure everything's on the up and up. We'll be fine. Speeding Wheeler.
And ladies and gentlemen, someone that you may be familiar with, star of many TV appearances, usually when it's snowing at the Hooks of Toll Plaza, please welcome Major David McCarthy.
Major Dave McCarthy behind the plate.
And remember, fans, tonight,
calling the balls and strikes.
The New Hampshire State Police, a round of applause is warranted. That's right, I want to add my own special thank you to the New Hampshire State Police for umpiring tonight's game. Because they were umpiring tonight's game, they were not on Route 9 between Hillsborough and Henniker, where I was doing considerably more than the double net call just a few minutes ago.
Getting our batting orders straightened away.
Unfortunately, due to the fact that Jim St. John refuses to sing the national anthem, when it's time to play ball, batter up with our first victim from the Busch series. Come to the plate.
Kevin Harvick.
Kevin Harvick's the second baseman. Tim Federer is the left center fielder.
He'll be on deck.
Mm-hmm.
And we're ready to play some softball here at Memorial Field in Concord.
And they're facing the pitcher. We got Barry Belanger.
And Barry Belanger, yeah, for the North squad.
A lefty. And he's ready to get it underway here. That does look like slow pitch. And he pops it in very shallow right field for a base hit. First pitch hitting there, Dave.
North guys running out in the field like they've got lead in their shoes already. Couldn't quite come up on that ball, so it drops in for a single.
Uh-huh.
And Pete, I don't know, I didn't see a lot of hustle on that first play of the game.
Please welcome Tim Fedewa.
Tim Fedewa up next.
Well, Tim Fedewa, the left center fielder.
He uses this equipment other than this game.
Go, Timmy.
Strike one.
And you're going to have to straighten me out here on the balls and strikes here, Pete, because...
Well, yeah, one and one the count.
I never got high marks for my umpiring skills back in Little League.
Well, hit to left field. Left fielder going back on it. Makes a grab. One out.
Bryon Chu made that play. The rookie driver out of Matatuck, New York. His first big play of the season.
There he is, ladies and gentlemen.
Bryon Chu took care of business. One away.
And Elton Sawyer will come up. And the ball to Elton Sawyer.
Elton Sawyer looks somewhat tentative at the plate. Must be very worried about whether or not he can continue the Busch South dominance over the Busch North drivers. Looks a little concerned out there as he takes the third pitch.
Yeah, that's going to be a ball. It better be. Talk about throwing it deep.
It's funny how they can shake them off like that, though. That looked awful good to me, but...
A little too deep, probably. And ball four. Talk about patience at the plate, Dave. Or do we want to talk about it?
Well, you know, it's just as well that Elton did get that walk because, like I said, he was looking awfully tentative at the plate. I don't think he could have done anything with that sort of pitching here this early in the game.
Oh, no.
We'll see if he's got anything left in the later innings.
I'm not sure if a veteran hitter could have done anything with that kind of pitching. Mike Dillon, the left fielder, is a hitter.
Whoa.
White pops it up high in the left fielder. He's Bryon Chu under it.
Bryon Chu's got the ball. Bryon Chu makes the second out for the Busch North squad here. What a great catch. High, but just didn't have the distance to go over that left field fence. Chu is under it. Makes a second good play of the inning.
Here's Lyndon Amich. Get his first at bat.
Lyndon
Amich.
Lyndon was all state in baseball.
Bryon Chu just being patient out there, making a couple of good catches. You could say they might be routine, but I don't know if any catch is routine. You've got to make sure you
right to the
beat on it. Yep, center field.
Right up the
base
center
hit,
field.
And they're going to send him coming from in, and the throw to third. Not at times, it's 1-0.
So he gets a double out of it, and one run crosses the plate.
Well, They shouldn't call that a double. That actually should be a single and a...
And an error?
Well, run it just a throw coming into third.
Giving Elton the signals as he does normally during the race.
Two outs and one across the plate. Still plenty of time in this game. 1-0 in favor of the Busch Grand National South drivers. North and South. Not quite as interesting as the Civil War, but it could be.
Jimmie Johnson.
Ooh, baseman. There we go.
Yep, second base, that should
Ozzie.
Be a routine play. It is.
Ozzie makes the play.
And the old-timer Ozzie Osbourne really got a hold of that one and drove it right to first base for a perfect strike. Gets the out. The inning is over. 1-0 in favor of the Busch South drivers. So a couple of good plays out there. We're showing a little spark of life, don't you think, Peter?
No, definitely. Definitely. But the Busch Series Grand National, they wind up taking the 1-0 lead. Oh, sure. When you're playing for a charity event, I'm sure you must have seen this before. It certainly is always something that's a pleasure to do.
I've seen it before. I'm trying to think. Last year, I did not make the game, but from what people told me, it was pretty ugly, and it was not something you wanted to watch.
It was one of those, what, 25-7 games,
yeah,
maybe?
Yeah, something like that. I tend to erase those bad memories from my mind. But now the Busch North drivers get to show their stuff at the plate. And from what we've been told over the last couple of weeks, we got some hitters in the lineup tonight.
Okay, and you'll have, who was it, Glenn Brio
will be the shortstop. He'll be batting first. He'll be followed in order by Bobby Dragon out of Vermont. And then Matt Kobyluck, the third baser, will be batting third. And if we get that far, Michael Olsen, the left center fielder.
Well, Al, this inning's yours.
Mike Olsen, the Little Trees driver.
Batter. Glenn Brio will advance to the plate.
Randy LaJoie looking a little tentative behind the plate tonight. He's the catcher for the Busch South squad, yelling out some things to the pitcher. Randy having a hard time getting the ball back to the pitcher's mound.
And we're going to be underway here, the bottom of the first inning.
Here we go.
And wrapped up the middle.
Right up the middle, Glenn Brio for a base hit.
Off single, trips at first base.
He really didn't have a chance on that. It was hit so hard, the pitcher couldn't get down on it, and the second baseman couldn't get to it. So this is a leadoff single, and Bobby Dragon will come up.
Ball took an awful hop.
So Ricky Hendricks couldn't get anything on that one at all. It just flew right by him.
Another one. He'll step on second, one to first, double play.
Double play ball by Bobby Dragon. He batted into that one, and one and two are out of there. So Matt Kobyluck up to the plate a lot sooner than he expected to be this evening. And Ricky Hendrick is... Starting to catch this. Got instant replay on this. Here's the play. That's the first one, rather.
And of course.
And you see the center fielder pick up the ball, get it to first, but the second hit, nothing doing. They learned how to stop them fast. Kobyluck.
Yeah, that's high in the air to left center field. Shallow left center, and who's going to get it? The shortstop finally winds up making the catch.
Well, it wasn't pretty. They looked like the Three Stooges out there in left field, center field, and short. But the Busch South guys managed to get out of that inning. And the score is still 1-0 at the top of the second inning. Hey, we're going to the top of the second. So we do have some, we got some batters out here. We just got to
do.
Just got to teach them to get the ball up and over. Typical New England weather. You never know what to expect. Here's our first pitch of the second inning.
And that's going to be a ball inside. No, you sure don't know what to expect with the weather. It can be 80 degrees one day and then 50 3 days later. Back for the middle. Shortstop, nice play, but not in time. He was ready to bang him out at first base, and he couldn't do it.
He was safe. Obviously, that umpire had been drinking earlier with the Busch South squad last night when they came into town, so we'll hope his eyes get a little bit better. I thought the tie always went to the runner. Got the replay right here. Here it comes. Nice stab there. Throws it, and it's a bullet. The tie goes to the runner. I don't know what game that umpire was watching, Pete, but that looked awful close to me. But that's okay. It's for charity, and it's a lot of fun.
And hit the ball, hit out to right field, and he makes a catch, even though he misjudged it. And he goes back to first. Not in time. He
lost his hat on that one.
Even lost his hat in that play. That will not.
But that was a good catch. Here comes the replay as we look, and we've got a couple of guys running for the same ball as we had before. Nice catch, down on his backside. Rolls around a little in the mud, and he's all set.
That's one he's going to frame forever in his file.
Randy LaJoie, formerly of New England, down around Norwalk, Connecticut. Been brainwashed by the Busch South folks now. He should be playing with us, you know, New England, Connecticut, Busch North, but... Randy has his allegiances made in the South Tour.
Mm-hmm. He has a fly ball going out to center. The left center fielder came over and couldn't make the grab. And I think that'll be an error out there.
So Mike Olsen, for that ridiculous play, will only get one lap of qualifying tomorrow afternoon at New Hampshire International Speedway. He'll be fine.
Randy should have been credited with a double. But Randy was gracious and stayed at first base.
So Mike Olsen missed that one. We've got...
What do we got, Kevin back?
What do we got, two outs here? We got one out.
Good, one out.
One out.
And he pitches a ball.
And that's...
Mike Barkowski.
No, Mike Barkowski.
Barkowski hits a drive, and it's going to be
there
caught.
We go.
Out there in right center.
Nice play. He redeemed himself on that one. So two away, top of the second inning.
And we go back to the top of the order to Kevin Harvick, is it?
Yep, Kevin Harvick.
Kevin Harvick.
Running for his first full season in the Busch Grand National Division.
He scored the... only run in this game so far.
I know he enjoys that name so much.
And they call him Kevin the Kid Harvick. Kid Rock. And Kid Rock follows one back.
There's a souvenir for the fans by Kid Rock as he loops one into the visiting bench.
Hopefully he can drive a little bit straighter than he hits the ball out on the track this weekend.
Well, he got a single in his first time off. Let's give
him
credit.
He did. You got to keep the pressure on these guys, though. We don't want these.
No, you want to win. You want this. You got to have the North win here.
Yes. Yeah.
It's a 1-1 count.
I mean, it's not like we're favoring the North squad at all, but we want to keep the pressure on the South.
No, not like you favored it. No. Not at all.
No. We don't want it to even seem like that. I mean, it should be played.
No, you're out of order. The whole game's out of order. He's legal.
Well, catcher having a problem with the order. It's probably right too, because our
it's right according if they're running batting 10, they're going. That's right. That's right.
Jim St. John very rarely ever makes mistakes. They're saying they batted out of order, but they're going to let it slide.
Which they didn't actually.
Probably not. No. But it sounds good for
it
our
sounds
viewers.
Good for our purposes. Right. Pop up third baseman will handle it.
Hey, there we go. Your third baseman Matt Kobyluck.
That's the end of the inning.
So.
Busch series.
1-0. Busch Grand National drivers are leading, but a very fleeting lead as the North drivers are getting geared up. We're going to take a short break from our Busch North versus South game live from Memorial Field in Concord on New England Cable Channel 12. I'm Dave Stevens, and Pete Barker will be back in just a moment.
Mach 5 has been sabotaged. Speed, if you don't win, we could lose everything.
Here, Speed.
Huh? The Volkswagen GTI.
Faster, Speed.
Look out! This GTI is amazing, and it's got room for four.
Make that six.
On the road of life, there are passengers, and there are drivers.
Go, Speed Racing, go!
We're back.
Mm-hmm, as we are.
Didn't mean to step on you, Peter.
No, I'm sorry. We are back.
Memorial Field in Concord, the site of where we hope North will once again rule the South in the Busch North Series drivers against the Busch Grand National drivers here at Memorial Field. And this is our fifth year that we've done this for charity. All proceeds go to benefit the Ronald McDonald House.
And a decent crowd, very good crowd here tonight. Ground ball, second base, he misplays it. Hit the inside of his foot as he wanted to go down and get to it. That's going to be an error as Olsen leads it off here for the Busch North team.
So Kevin Harvick, after hitting a single, has really muffed it up out in the field there with that play. Harvick, of course, trying to improve, but he looks like he's getting a little tired out there, Pete. Maybe Harvick's only good for a couple of innings.
It could be.
You don't want to get into trouble, do you?
I'm going to let you get into most of the trouble.
Up next, the 0-9 from Matatuck, New York. It's Bryon. He made two spectacular plays out in left field the first inning.
Ooh.
Swings at a nasty pitch.
Well, I don't know if you want to say it was a nasty swing.
That was a nasty pitch, too. I don't know.
Hendricks loved that, huh?
He's going to hurt himself.
Here he comes again. Now he's going to let up on it.
Yeah.
And it's going to be a ball. Well, it's going to be a 2-1 count.
Chew, a professional ball player in the offseason.
There's a foul back here on the left side.
Bryon actually played ball in high school for 5 years, and I believe he played a little college ball, too.
John Lesniak, the right center fielder, the on-deck hitter. Here's your pitch. And
there we
slammed
go.
Slammed to left field, base hit. Boy, that was just right out there for the taking, Dave.
So Bryon is 3-for-3, a couple of good plays, and has hit his first time up at bat. And up next, as you said, it's going to be the right center fielder, John Lesniak. So two men on, this could be it.
Yep, one is on first and second.
Big hit,
drive to left center field. That will load the bases for Busch North. Wow, he got a threat going here in the second inning with nobody out.
Now, here comes the pitcher. I believe this is Barry Belanger.
Should be.
Better be.
We got a timeout.
We got a timeout. Things get tough down south. You know what happens? They just fold like a $2 bill, and they've got to take a timeout. And the pressure is just becoming a little bit too intense for our brethren drivers down south. We'll see what they're talking about. Probably taking the drink order for after the game, for all we know, but...
You so, never know. Here's Barry Belanger. Let's see what he can do to change this score. Nothing at that point, as it's a ball.
Belanger takes a high pitch from Hendrick.
And the next pitch is
ripped nice
down the line, and it's going to be caught as he goes into foul territory, and they didn't tag up.
Broke up through.
No tag up on that.
No tag up. He had plenty of time to get there. Michael waiting for maybe the next softball game to go ahead and run on that one. He probably should have been gone. What do you think, Pete?
Maybe he just didn't want to bother with it. I don't know.
Now, who's
the next pitch, and that's outside.
This looks like Mike. No, this looks like Mike Bruno up to bat.
Mike being heckled.
Mike Bruno is up to bat. Ozzie's just playing second base. I guess Ozzie's got nothing going on the bat, so Mike Bruno substituting. Good eye on Bruno. Making Hendrick work the count. And Hendrick's about to walk the next run in and tie the score if he's not careful.
Yeah, 3-0 the count. Oh, here's the pitch, and it's hit out to center field. It's going to be another catch. They're going to tag. This time he tagged. Here comes the throw. That's way, way off.
We don't know where they learned to throw the ball down south, but that wasn't going anywhere near the plate. So another run.
Like,
one run comes across.
He was throwing it basically towards the dugout.
I think he was throwing it to a fan or something. He saw a pretty skirt in the field out in the stands over here, Pete, and he just went that way with it, not paying attention to the game. So two away, but they tie the game up.
Olsen came in this time. No, is this Varney?
Wow, way off to the right.
Way foul.
Foul ball.
You should have dropped the popcorn to catch that ball. Not good team spirit out there.
I gather the batter is Varney. Is that what we're...
I'm going to say it's Randy Varney.
Randy. That's who we had in the lineup.
If you have a chance,
yeah, it looks like Randy Varney. I've never met Randy Varney, but I'm sure I'm sure that could be him.
Well, that's
of course, not terribly formal in this charity softball game.
No.
So if you're watching at home saying, gosh, the announcers don't know the drivers. Well, we've just met them for the first time, and Next time you see them next year on Channel 12, you'll know who they are.
And you'll know them better than I will. That's for sure. Fouls another one off. Talk about trying to pull it. Ooh. So two strikes the count on Varney.
Sir, a little help over there.
Tony Edwards is at the plate. He's
Tony Edwards.
That's
okay.
Who that is.
They did it to us again.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's okay.
Varney never got up then.
Varney might be having some unspecified health-related problems mm-hmm. that prevent him from batting. Like he can't hit the ball. I don't know. could mm-hmm. be one of the things.
Well, we don't know what that. 1-2 the count.
Second and third. That one's down.
Here's a rip to
ooh.
First. And that ends the inning. What a shot.
So Tony Edwards hits one directly to the first baseman. But the score is tied 1-1. As we go into the top of the third.
And that it is.
And a young fan doing what we should be doing, having a cheeseburger or a hot dog.
Well, we already had the Big Mac bet. So.
Actually, it was a quarter pounder. Something about race weekends, I always gain 5 pounds. Oh. I don't understand how that works. Here comes the replay, and watch him go up and get that ball.
Well, I don't know, this Bush North team.
That couldn't have been any straighter to him, though, if he had asked for it.
No, but you're going to make a catch on those, Dave.
Good crowd on hand tonight.
Good crowd, as you can see, the stands on both sides are full.
Yeah, both sides are full.
Pretty
I'd
full.
I'd say about 600 people, 500-600 people in attendance here tonight. Of course, the autograph session, we had quite a few more here that came down to meet the Busch North and the Busch South Series drivers, get their autographs, take some pictures, have some fun. So it's been a great afternoon.
Not short on skills. Here he comes to the plate. Tim Fedewa.
Tim Fedewa.
Tim Fedewa up next to bat for the South boys.
Flew out to left in the first inning.
Tim, by the way, I'm very...
Ooh, you got stats.
Well, yeah, I'm trying to keep some scoring straight.
I like that.
Well, that was one of those catches Bryon made.
Yeah.
Remember, Bryon made a couple of catches on fly balls to left.
Had a nice hit in the second inning.
Here in the third inning, top of, and another drive to left field.
Uh-oh.
This time Bryon won't get that one. It's going to roll in, and that will be...
Good for...
Three. It's going to be three.
This is the cutoff, guys.
No, he sure did. Here's the throw, and we got a home run for Fedewa. We got to give him, even though the cutoff throw we missed, give him a home run.
So Tim Fedewa, obviously with lead in his bat, knocks one way out to left field. Chu didn't really have a chance at that one. It was just traveling too fast. Anything moving that fast should have had a stewardess on it, don't you think, Pete?
Here's I can agree with you.
Here's the replay. You see Chu going back. He had a jump on the ball, but that thing was hauling out of here.
That was an easy, easy triple. But you know what? I think he would have beaten it out anyway because of the way that throw came in.
Yeah, yeah. Bryon threw to second, didn't think Fedewa had the speed.
And
here comes a high pop fly.
Sawyer.
This could be trouble.
Catch. It was trouble. He misjudged it. Sawyer, I guess.
So that an easy play
50-50 tonight.
Gone by the wayside by the shortstop. Glenn Brio really should have had that one. No excuse whatsoever.
Help us out tonight with our big.
But that's okay. We'll allow him that one. Everybody's allowed one mistake in this game.
Pitch is called a ball. The next hitter, Mike Dillon?
Mike Dillon,
the left fielder, is the hitter for Busch North.
Busch South.
Or the Busch Series Grand National people.
Yeah, Busch Grand National. Right. Oh, gosh.
Well, if you want to call it the Busch, or as they refer to it, as the Busch Series Softball All-Stars.
There you go.
Mm-hmm.
That's who they say they are.
Yeah, they're confident they can do something here. We're going to miss. Woohoo! Trying to go for the downs on that one, Mr. Dillon, and it's 2-2.
Franco Butler just commented there might be something on that ball. We might have to have that check, though.
Here's the delivery. That's a full count at 3-2.
3-1. We're getting reports of Ben Gay on the softball. Could you check that, please,
And here is the pitch, and he pops it up, foul territory, third base side,
ooh.
And third baseman never Kobyluck really got comfortable under it, did he?
Kobyluck, Freddy's scared of the ball. That's what it looked like. He was he kind of looked like one of my kids at Little League on that play. But that's okay. We'll let Matt have that one. That's the last one you get, though, Mr. Kobyluck. Here it is again. Kobyluck looks. He's got it. Now he's going to duck. And
that's what he did.
Yeah, he ducked. He took his eyes off the ball, and that's what happened to that.
Here's the pitch, and it's ripped, and that's what happens. Goes out to the gap between the left center fielder and the center fielder, and that wound up driving in one run.
Do you want to hear a joke why they run so fast down south? Or no, we better
not. No, we better not.
What do we get for outs? We have no outs.
But there should be a couple outs. The umpire checking to see if how many outs, and they're checking with Fred Neergaard, who should have said there were two outs, but Fred blowing that opportunity for the Busch North squad. But showing his, here comes.
Driver back up. So they're hitting now as we had, Lyndon Amich. Amich hitting a ball up. That's his second hit and his second RBI.
Lyndon Amick having a good night for himself here tonight.
I'm feeling much better now. This
okay, so Lyndon Amick 2-for-2 with two singles, two RBIs.
Amick's on a roll. Didn't Bryon have one out, though? Did he get catch one ball out there, or he lost one?
Mm-hmm. No, he didn't catch one. We started off.
Oh, Dr. Seven's going to take that one.
And the catch made there off the bat of Johnson.
That's right, he didn't catch one because the shortstop got in there. That's it. That's the play I'm trying to think of now. Memorial Field in Concord, the site of the fifth annual charity softball game between
Hendricks, the pitcher, will hit it high in the air to the infield. Should be caught at second. He does. Having trouble. Look, they're having a lot of trouble getting those balls. I wonder if it's the difference between the lights and the change in
the depth of perception.
The depth perception
must be different. So Bruno redeems himself, and
and who do we have up now? We have.
Well, that was Hendrick, the pitcher, and after Hendrick, the pitcher, we have. We'll open the sheet.
We'll have to get a. That's not the sheet we want.
That's not the one we want.
No, we need to check the official scorer here on that, I think.
P.J. Jones is
okay,
up.
Okay, P.J. Jones, okay.
I recognize his hat.
That stays fair, it's trouble.
Foul. Foul
by inches. By the way, we're
technically, after that triple by Dillon,
for sponsoring this inning. And by the way, there'll be no more.
You can give an error to the third baseman for not getting that pop-up, because if he gets that, you don't have the triple.
That's true.
So they have been having some problems out there.
Just a couple.
Mm-hmm.
It's a 4-1 game, though. The Busch North Stars are still in it.
Yeah, they are. And the
this could be a tough one.
There you got now. We've got
two
probably,
guys.
Two go after somebody didn't call it.
Got to call the ball, fellas. Got to call that ball. You see that happen a lot with the 12-year-olds and the high schoolers too, though. They they do it in the big leagues.
Jimmy, you better check. I don't think you have all that.
Well, and those are people that play together all the time.
Yeah.
Day in and day out. Yeah. Practice.
Which is what the Busch Grand National drivers do down south. When they're not driving cars, they play softball.
Oh, the Busch Grand National drivers.
Yeah,
okay,
that's all they do. Softball and racing. That's what they do. That's why they're this good. Up here, we have to work for a living. We have jobs,
base hit,
families. Bryon bobbles the ball a little out left.
Whoa, he sure does.
And that was ugly. But again, another working man out there doesn't have a lot of opportunity to spend playing ball and getting ready for these charity events. Randy LaJoie trades the lead bat for a legal bat now, thinking that they might not need any extra help after all.
Randy feeling a little bad for the North team, goes with a smaller bat, trying to make a little.
So LaJoie, the catcher, flied out to right field. And there's a drive. And they're not.